You know, we have to, you know, a couple of things, and one thing we need to, again, understand and clarify that, you know, the church is people. Mm-hmm. So here's the church right here. This is the church because you and I are gathered together in the name of Christ, and we're the church. It's not a building. And, you know, when I listen to some of our callers, again, I want to be very careful that I believe in the church, but there's no perfect church. Mm-hmm. And there's different types of church, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And sometimes we can get, and this isn't referencing to anyone's particular point, but I'm just picking up on the fact that, you know, sometimes it's easy to talk about all the bad, 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 but there's a ton of good that outweighs the bad.
That's right.
And that's what we really need to be key. Even the topic tonight, you know, it's good in a sense because it's making us wake up and realize, mm-hmm. Dr. Elaine, that, you know, we haven't been doing what we should be doing. And that doesn't mean that everybody, I'm sure there are churches where they are right in tune and right in line, mm-hmm. and it's happening. Probably the majority of them, maybe not. And I don't know that. But the point is, it's forcing us to reconsider and relook and recognize, you know what, we've got to do something.
Yeah.
And what do we want? I mean, we want the presence of God.
Yes.
And how you are going to get the presence of God is not by going out by yourself.
Right.
It's by coming together, yeah. as you talk about in your book, community.
Yeah.
And in that community of faith, together experience the presence and power,
right.
of God. When we become real,
that's right.
and open with one another.
And what I also want to say is that in this book, it's about affirming that people love the Lord, they go to church, they're not going to leave the church. It's mm-hmm. just that they have things. Church people have pain like anybody else. Mm-hmm. The distinction is the power of the cross. Mm-hmm. You know, the power of the cross to change people's lives. Mm-hmm. Because there are many people in the pews who have had private pain who have absolutely been delivered. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we don't hear those stories,
yeah.
so.
Yeah.
But I think we've come to a point of time that people in the church, the silent screams that I talk about, mm-hmm. we've got to remedy that.
Yeah.
Because, like we said, the power of the cross, people love God and they're going to continue to come to church, regardless of what people might think, mm-hmm. that because of pain they're going to leave. Many mm-hmm. are staying mm-hmm. and just waiting for their moment,
yeah.
where God's going to hear them, mm-hmm. and He is hearing them, mm-hmm. and He's going to do it for them.
Yes. Amen. I agree. I agree.